Hey guys, I'm on my way to a Subaru dealership. We had some ideas today, and we're looking hard at the Forester XT, mainly for me because it has the 2.0 turbo and it's easy to chip and tune. Those things, the XT is 250 horsepower, 258 torque stock. Looks like about a 6.4 second 0 to 60 stock, and you can get your Cobb access port, or there's some other tuning places I saw today that can get you around 5.8, 5.9 in the 0 to 60. That's pretty good for an SUV. Normally you're not going to find them that quick, and that's miles faster than the CX-5 was probably 7.8, I think I read, maybe 8 second average, 0 to 60. So eventually, if I can get it to like 5.8 versus 8 seconds, that's a gigantic difference. So I'm going over there now. We're looking at a lease on this thing. It's kind of hard to lose either way with a buy or lease on the Subaru because of the insane resale values. And at least with the lease, I'm probably not going to lose, and I can just decide later if we do want to keep it or not when the lease is up. And that always, of course, saves a lot of cash in your pocket because you're not paying the tax for a five-year loan on the same day. So that could save us a lot of money, keep cash in our pocket. So first step is I'm going to look at it myself, make sure I don't hate it. I mean, I've been researching it all day. It looks all right. It has a few weak points, like the touchscreen stereo, that shit like that. But overall, it looks like a decent family cruiser. A huge sunroof, which is super fun. That's one of my favorite things in cars, is just a big, like the T-tops and the Wrangler, or the big panoramic sunroofs. This thing does have that. Anyway, I don't want to go on for too long. I'm going to look at it now. If it passes my test, then the wife has to come look at it. Time is always a struggle. My hours just changed at work, and I got to work all day now. I don't get half a day free like I used to. So all day, both us and the wife, me and the wife work. We're not gonna have any time to go like look at cars and stuff. Probably only Saturdays, Sundays, starting now. Today's a holiday, so I got one little chance to go look at this. I'll end this for now. Maybe I'll get a clip once I get there. Forgot to even tell you, you guys are probably sitting there going, wait, what the hell? What happened to the Scat Pack? The more I think about it, the more I just think I can't afford it. It's not a smart move to get something super expensive when you're not that well off money-wise. And sure, it's a dream, I'd love it, but that's a long 5 years of super high payments, not really making my family suffer, but just not making us comfortable as far as that payment. So the Scat Pack dream sort of drifted away in the last few weeks. I mean, it's all I've been thinking about. I just can't spend $510 to $530 or $540 a month on the car in our current family situation with finances. I just can't do it. So unfortunately, that's what happened to my dream for now. We're gonna go a different route, and I'll feel better financially for sure, although it won't be as fun as a Scat Pack. Here's the blue. That's about the same color as our CX-5 was. This blue is a little bit nicer, actually. Can you see there? This is the white, more of a creamy kind of white. Not a bright white like the Dodge. Look at this. Door panels. This one does still have the 8 speaker rather than the 6, though.
Harman Kardon.
Okay. The seats are actually more comfortable than I thought. These are probably more comfortable than the CX-5 seats. Interior does look pretty good. Is the HomeLink mirror standard on the XT, or it's an option? Okay, no problem.
I think it's an option.
Let's look. Oh, the sunroof thing doesn't open unless the keys in it, huh? Keep people out. All right. look in there. A little bit outdated climate, but that's not that big a deal. Different modes for the shifter. This does have the selectable transmission modes and all that on the Touring, right? And the CVT cup holders. Let's look at the big deep console I read about. That's real good. And you get the seat heaters. That's good too. Automatic opening hatch is nice. Our CX-5 didn't have that. One thing we missed when we were cross-shopping stuff a while back. Really spacious back seat. Tons of room. Looks like more room than the GTI even. And that's saying a lot. Really spacious back seat. Hatch is smaller, but it's at least as big as a GTI hatch, if nothing else. You could fit a couple strollers in there. Nice touch.
Lumbar support.
Just basically in and out adjustment on that?
Up and down.
It does have up and down too? Or you're saying?
To lower the cushion to
Oh, right.
Necessary point.
Oh, for the whole seat.
Lumbar support.
It's pretty much all adjustable. Is the passenger not adjustable? Is that what I read?
Correct.
Yeah. So we got the lumbar. Does the passenger have lumbar or not? Only driver, okay. Very light hood, I noticed. It just took tiny, tiny pressure. I always liked the design of the Subaru engines. Super cool looking. All right, thanks. Nice ducting right there from the hood. Is it a... Oh, there's nothing there. That's pretty much totally fake. It's kind of strange. I guess it scoops from somewhere, but there's no hole in the hood. So whatever this is cupping over, okay. All it's just gonna scoop from the air coming in, but not from outside of the hood. Nice little heat blanket material right there. I'm probably gonna turn off the clip for the stereo and turn it back on because I'm not going to be able to include that clip. I can't put music on in the car, you know, all the copyright rules. 71 miles. It's had a few test drives. That's probably why it's the only one that's unlocked. You have a small screen out here. It's kind of cool. I heard that the backup camera, let me test it, is up here. Yep. And you got your backup camera right there. That's a really good stereo, guys. I wish you could have heard it. Really, really strong bass. Possibly blows away my GTI. I think this thing has subwoofers, so that would explain it. And far, far better than the CX-5 stereo. This is the Harman Kardon, remember. And you can get the, if you get the navigation package, you get a touchscreen, but that isn't that great a system from reputation. So you're probably good just with staying with this system here. Avoiding all the slow touch reactions and all that, and just going with the basic stereo here. Show you the white one more time. If this was my car, I'd want the white myself. Maybe the blue, but probably the white. This has a much different fascia. I probably mentioned that. It's way better than the non-XT version, I think. Looks super aggressive, don't you think? I don't know if this is a DRL halo or anything. It sure looks like it. That'd be pretty awesome if it is. Overall, I do really like the look of this car. And one look at the silver. Gotta show the wife the color choices. Silver and the light. It's not bad. It doesn't really pop. If you want to kind of blend in, the silver might be a better choice. I think it's not as exciting or sharp looking as the white myself. But I'm a white car guy, and not too many people agree with me. Coming back to that blue again, tough choice on the blue versus the white for me personally. I think the white wins myself, honestly. The blue is nice, but the white
with the black. I've just always been the contrast guy. It just pops. This is a little more laid back to me. So one more view of the blue before I get out of here.
On the way back home now. I didn't test drive it myself. That'll come later. She's the one that needs to test drive it. But overall, I was real pleased with that car viewing. There was very little to complain about. I really couldn't think of a lot. I couldn't speak totally freely because the salesman guy was there the whole time. That was a Carlson Subaru, by the way. It doesn't matter if I tell you where it was. And a nice salesman there, Larry. So, and I did deal with him on WRX negotiations a couple of years back, and it kind of fell through. But I love the look of the Forester, especially the front. And the interior was better than I expected, honestly. The seats were softer than the CX-5. I could tell right away. The CX-5 was like sitting on boards. These ones were more comfortable, I could tell. And the stereo blew me away, actually. I think it's better than both the CX-5 and the GTI, as I said. So there's no problems with the stereo volume. She'll love that. It may not be as clear as my GTI one, but it was definitely as loud, had a real nice punch to it. As he said, if you want the navigation, it only comes with the EyeSight option, which a lot of people don't really want, and the navigation sucks on the Subarus. He kind of hinted at that. I didn't say that to his face. But the navigation is really poor with low resolution and slow response. So that makes it easier. You don't need to get the EyeSight, which automatically adjusts your speed and brakes for you like the CX-5 had. And you can do away with the navigation at the same time. And that's like a $2,000 option. So that makes it real nice. And the lease numbers, I went through a quick lease just to get an idea with them. A 3-year lease, 10,000 miles a year. So you definitely want the 10,000 miles a year on a car like this, especially. Even if you go over on the miles, it's very unlikely you're going to end up underwater. That's one of the main reasons to aim for this brand in my situation and always getting rid of cars. This car holds better value than probably anything, period. Even better than a Wrangler. This car is number one in holding its value. So let me get back to the lease real quick. I don't want to keep boring you. 3 years, 10,000 miles. The salesman actually recommended I put as little down as possible. It's kind of rare that they're on your side on that. And he was on my side. I was saying, you know, $3,000. He goes, you should probably put down a little less. I went, all right, that sounds good to me. So with 2,000 down, it is only $325 a month, including tax. That is crazy low, because I got a competitive lease quote earlier in the day from a different dealer, 3,000 down, and it was about $330 a month. I gotta check the forums. I can't remember exactly what I said, or check my email, it's smarter. But that is a really cheap price, $325 all in per month. Only $2,000 out of pocket. Can put the other $8,000 we got out of the CX-5 into the bank. Seems like a win-win. Of course, the wife does need to drive it, make sure it doesn't suck. And the exciting part for me is I would definitely chip tune this, whatever, Cobb tuning, bump it up maybe 30 horsepower and 40 torque to make it really fun. And I think I could make a lot of good modding videos with this too, play around with it a little bit. It'd be like my second toy. I would be keeping this GTI, of course. Over the last few weeks, I've kind of, which always happens, grown to love my GTI more and more again after driving shit boxes, and the GTI is just so pleasurable right now. I got to take it out even though the wife's using it. I took it out on this little errand, so I'm super stoked. Anyway, let me stop talking here. This video's getting too long.